All right, this is a pretty interesting question for derivative. Check this out. We are going to find dy dx for the equation x to the y's power that's equal to y to the x power. Well, here's the y and likewise here's the y. And the problem with this question is that the base right here is x. It's a function. Likewise, the exponent. Likewise, here the base is a function and likewise the exponent. So in this case, what we are going to do first is we are going to take the natural log on both sides. And the reason is because this way, we can bring the power to the front. We can bring the power to the front. And do not minus 1 because this is just the log property. It's not the power rule for the derivative. And when we have that, this is what we are going to get. We will just have x times ln x. Sorry, y times ln x. That's equal to x times ln y. All right? So from here, we can just do implicit differentiation. And we see we just need to use the product rule here and also the product rule here. So again, this is what we will do. If we have to differentiate, when the expression that the base is a function, likewise the power is also a function, then you do the natural log on both sides. Okay, let's put on d dx. We're differentiating this with respect to x. Here we go. This right here is a product of this and that. Let's keep the first function, which is y, and we multiply by the derivative of the second. The derivative of ln x is 1 over x. Good. And then we add the second function, which is ln x. And then we multiply by the derivative of the first. Derivative of y is exactly what we want, namely dy dx. And then we continue on the right-hand side. Same thing, but different order. We first keep this function, which is x, and then we multiply by the derivative of this, which is 1 over y. But this is not it, because y is a function of x. So we will have to multiply by dy dx here because of the chain rule. All right? So be really careful with this part here. And then we are going to add the second function, which is ln y, and we multiply by the derivative of the first. Derivative of x is just equal to 1. Okay, so this is what we have. And now, what exactly can we do with this? Well, we see that this is an equation that has fractions because we have the x right here on the denominator, likewise this, right? So it's a good idea to multiply everybody by the common denominator, which is the x and also the y. So let's do that first. So when we take this, multiply with that, the x and x will cancel. Y times y, we first get y squared. And then we will add this, multiply with that, we have xy times ln x and then dy dx. And perhaps I'm going to keep the dy dx in red. Let's focus on the dy dx. Continue, this times that, the y will cancel, x times x, we get x squared, and then here we have that dy dx. And then lastly, we just add this times that, let's put it as xy, and then we have the ln y. Cool. Now, I'm going to move this to the other side, and then we'll move this to the right-hand side. So here, let me open the parentheses. Let's put this down first, which is xy ln x minus x squared, because we put this to the other side already. So that's why this becomes a minus. And we will have the dy dx here. And that's equal to, let's keep this first, which is xy ln y, and we minus the y squared. And when the expression is written like this, usually it means the y is the only thing inside and the minus y is on the outside, so we just keep it like that. And ladies and gentlemen, we can just divide this on both sides and we will be done. So finally, let me put it down here. Big and clear, dy dx, let me write it down better for you guys. Dy dx for this right here is equal to that xy ln y and then minus y squared over that, which is xy ln x, and then minus x squared. Yep, that's what we have. So this right here is the answer for that.